So my name is Vanessa Castillo. My role with Gradient is I am the lead technician for the Southern region. I work with growers in almonds, pistachios, tomatoes. We help them make data-informed decisions out in their crops.
My name is Javier Garrido. I work with the Gradient team, mostly doing the software development on the back end for the platform. And I also work on the R&D team, doing some research and analyzing some data.
So my name is Exad Jimenez, and I'm the field lead tech for Gradient in the Northern region.
The entire idea with Gradient is, let's try to look at agriculture, paint a complete picture for a grower that takes all the different parameters that are important into account so that they can take the best decisions for the crop. That's everything having to do with weather, evapotranspiration, atmospheric pressure, relative humidity, then what's happening underneath, right? Whether it's volumetric water content or electroconductivity, any soil understanding, then critically, what is happening to the crop? What is the crop experiencing? And then lastly, how does this specific data point apply to the rest of my field? Is it representative of the rest of my field?
It's important to incorporate all of the measurements just because, you know, plant stress and soil moisture is not necessarily related. So for example, we can have high soil moisture or perfect soil moisture and your crop can be stressing due to something else. These sensors are able to detect stress before the human eye is able to see it. So in applications such as sulfur dusting or vine trimming, vine training, anything like that, it would be able to detect that basically immediately before the human eye, of course, would be able to do so. First, we have a pressure switch, which is telling us the irrigation hours that are being applied. We have the Taros 10, which are measuring at three different depths, 8 inches, 16 inches, and 24 inches. Basically, what we're getting from that is soil moisture readings. We are monitoring plant stress index through the Apogee sensor, which gives us canopy temperature. The Atmos 14, which is giving us relative humidity, air temperature, and vapor pressure deficit. And of course, everything is connected onto our CL6 logger. Along with all of that, we are also doing satellite imagery to basically see the whole picture.
The crop stress parameter is one of the things that differentiates Gradient from a lot of the competition. And we believe it's one of the key components that's missing in the industry when you're looking at agriculture. When we started doing the research, funnily enough, we were only using soil moisture sensors and we were trying to cut back the water to stress the crop to do deficit irrigation, right? Which is stressing towards the end of the season to increase the quality. And we realized very quickly that if you just use the moisture sensors, you can get into a pickle where you think your crop looks good, you cut too much water, and then by the time you come back the next day, just because the soil moisture sensors aren't as reactive when you're trying to do deficit irrigation, you could have lost some of your crop. So that actually happened to one of my colleagues, and really we started looking for alternatives, and that's where the infrared, the Apogee infrared came in. It's a really, really great tool at looking at canopy temperature, which is one of the key components in our stress parameter. So now we have this alternative sensor that is much more reactive to what is happening to the crop itself, right? When we cut back water, before you could see the damage visually, the stress that's coming from obviously the infrared is going to react immediately. You'll see that on the chart. It shoots up right away, right? And you can go out to the field and it looks the exact same as yesterday, so you wouldn't know any different without the sensor. And that crop stress really helps us drive those decisions towards the end of the season when we're doing deficit or when we're trying to be very efficient with our watering, right? A grower might be used to doing 8 hours a day every other day, and if we suggest we want to do 6, we can rely on this sensor and this crop stress to let us know if that's not enough, if it's too short, because that crop is going to start steadily going up. And then as soon as you come back in with some more water, it kind of steadies back down. So yeah, it's a critical component of our system. I'd almost say it wouldn't be like navigating blind, but it'd be like navigating with an eye closed without using any of the components, not just the IR, but the moisture and the environment. So you need all that whole picture to understand what's happening.
I had a grower call me, I want to say maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago, that his sister wanted to thank me because their pump is usually, their pump bill to pump their orchards is usually somewhere around $3,000 to $4,000 a month to pump just for your orchards, right? And right now her bills are coming anywhere between $8,000 to $1,200 a month. And his trees have never looked better.
One of the best success stories that I have is from a grower. He was actually growing tomatoes for the very first time. He is an almond grower. Almond and cotton is what he was growing. So he was a little bit of unsure on how to do his irrigations. So we worked with him that very first year. We gave him all the information, recommendations, and he was a little bit unsure. He did not feel very comfortable. So he didn't listen to a lot of the recommendations that we were giving. That first year, he didn't do too well. But following the second year, he actually listened to all of the recommendations. And he doubled his yield. Third year came along. He had a lot more trust. So at this time, you know, he definitely was following everything that we said. Very, very worked together very, very closely throughout the whole season. And from that time moving forward, he did and continues to do well with his yields and tomatoes.
It's really fulfilling to see a grower who might have been a little scared of using a cell phone in the past now pull up the irrigation chart or the volumetric water content chart on their phone in the field when they're taking those decisions, right? That's very fulfilling for us to see.